Hi, folks. The other morning, I saw a TV news feature on the return of home milk delivery due to the pandemic. Of course, there was a time when you had your milk delivered from the dairy to your home by a milkman. The early morning rattle of the glass milk bottles was as common as the sound of the UPS truck is today. Milkman, Keep Those Bottles Quiet, was a 1944 World War II hit for Ella Mae Morse, a young big band vocalist going solo. Ella Mae was originally hired by Jimmy Dorsey when she was only 14 years old. She gave upstart Capitol Records its first gold record with Cow Boogie in 1942 when she was 17. Milkman was also a song about Rosie the Riveter. During World War II, over 18 million American women worked in manufacturing plants to provide armament, warplanes, supplies, and munitions, which enabled the U.S. and our allies to victory. Let's hear from Ella Mae Morse with Milkman, Keep Those Bottles Quiet.
Jumping on the swing ship all night, turning out my quota. All right, now I'm beat right down to the sod. Gotta catch myself some righteous nod. So milkman, keep those bottles quiet. Milkman, stop that grade A riot. Cut out if you can't lullaby it. Oh, milkman, keep those bottles quiet. Been knocking out a fat tank all day, working on a bomber. Okay, boy, you blast my wig with those clinks, and I got to catch my 40 winks. So, milkman, keep those bottles quiet. The Riveter, I don't mind it, cause the man with the whiskers has a lot behind it, but I can't keep punching with the victory crew when you're making me punch you with that bottle moo. I wanna give my all if I'm gonna give it, but I gotta get my shut eye if I'm gonna rip it. So bail out, bud, with that milk barrage, cause it's unpatriotic, it's a sabotage. All day, working on a bomber. Okay, boy, you blast my wig with those clinks, and I got to catch my 40 winks. So, milkman, keep those bottles quiet. Ooh, milkman, keep those bottles quiet. Ooh, milkman, keep those bottles quiet.
Quiet!
We certainly owe our thanks to the millions of Rosie the Riveters who played an essential part in the path to victory in World War II. Ella Mae Morse continued to have much success through 1946 with other hits such as The House of Blue Lights and The Blacksmith Blues. She was popular with both white and black audiences, and she continued to record for Capitol Records until 1957. Well, that's it for this time. Thank you, and hope you enjoyed the musical ride, and hope to have you back again.